Harry, I fell to an animal presentation entitled Creatures of the Night. Now just before putting on with the show, there are actually two gentle reminders I'm going to need all of you to take note of. Now if you take a look throughout the amphitheater, now you notice that we have our number 1, number 2, as well as number 3. We will be having animals that will be making its way down from all over the amphitheater, so please remain seated until I say thank you and good night. Now the second announcement is the most important one. As we are all the night safari, our animals here are nocturnal, which means they are very sensitive to bright lights as well as flashes. I understand that all of you here would like to take pictures of our animals, but please do so in a safe manner by remembering to turn off the flashes of your cameras. And since this is a very important message, I'm going to try and translate this message into 3 different languages. Now please bear with me, alright, because I am not very good at it. First up, do we have any Tamil speaking audience in the crowd tonight? Any Tamil speaking audience? No? Someone? Silence. Okay. I shall move on then. Any Malay speaking audience in the crowd tonight? Any Malay speaking audience? Yes? You wanted to raise your hand? No? Yes? Okay, 1. 2. Very shy one. And none over there. Okay, for the 2 of you. Selamat malam. Tolong jangan menggunakan flash camera anda, boleh? Terima kasih and yes, do see your flash over there. Okay, next up. Last one. Do we have any Mandarin speaking audience in the crowd tonight? 晚上好! 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 你好吗?
好.
请不要用闪光灯好不好? 谢谢你们. And can we all do that for the welfare of animals? Okay, thank you so much. Now we all that said, are you guys ready for the show? No, you guys are not ready. What kind of response is that? I'm going to ask you another time. Are you guys ready for the show? Thank you, that's more like it. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, the creatures of the night will be on the prowl. As the night falls, two worlds, one of sunlight, we are the moonlight, blend into one. Animals like the common raccoon comes out in search for food before heading home for the night. Using its sharp claws, it searches for its favorite insects, worms, snails, and even the prized egg. When satisfied, they return back to his big raccoon family and curl up in the same burrow for the night. Hidden among the shadows, nocturnal animals emerge from the dark silhouettes of the forest. With a body stripe to provide perfect camouflage, a fishing cat appears along the riverbank. This animal loves to swim and dive underwater in search for food. There's a layer of fur so short and dense that water cannot penetrate through it. It's also this layer that helps keep them warm and dry even in chilly waters. This animal is not doing so well in the wild because of habitat loss as well as poaching. Now it is our duty to protect this quiet hunter before it disappears forever. again, a very good evening everyone, and welcome to the world of the night hunters. Now, I've often been asked, how do nocturnal animals survive in the dark? Well, all our animals are unique and adapted for survival in the wild, for example, the big turtle. Jet black in color and almost invisible at night, this animal can be found in Southeast Asia rainforest, and they have an excellent sense of smell. Next one, this is Aslan, and Aslan is our Bintu. Now, Bintus are also known as the Asian redhead because of their bear-like walk and also their stubby face. But in fact, these Bintus are actually known for their long, prehensile tail, as you can see. And prehensile tail means it also acts as an additional limb. Now, in fact, it is so strong, it's easily able to support their entire body weight as they hang down from the branches of the tree. How strong that tail is. Now, Bintus can have an average lifespan of about 20 years, which is relatively long for such a small mammal. Now, ladies might want to listen up to this. The females are the dominant sex in the species, and they give it up to 20% heavier than their males. Now, it looks like Aslan is heading back. Once again, let's give a round of applause for Aslan. Thank you so much, Aslan. Bintus actually belongs in the civet family and they have an excellent strong sense of smell. The other animals rely on their hearing sense of power, and that will be the owl. Now if you take a look on my right hand side, everyone, this is Rainbow. And Rainbow is a great horned owl carried by his favorite trainer, Sane. Now great horned owls can be found in the northern continent of America, and they are sometimes referred to as the tiger of the sky. Tiger of the sky, because they're one of the largest owls that can be found in that continent. Hi, please return your place, thank you. Now you take a look towards the center, staircase. Now this is Oscar. And Oscar is a Eurasian eagle owl, carried by his favorite trainer, Derek. Eurasian eagle owls are one of the largest species of owls we have in the world. And judging from their names, yes, this owl can be found in Europe as well as in Asia. And last but not least, towards the left-hand side, everyone, this is a very noisy owl that goes by the name of Midnight, carried by his favorite trainer, James. Now, Midnight is a Malay fish owl, otherwise known as the Buffy fish owl, and it can be found right here in Singapore, Indonesia, Malaysia, as well as the Philippines. Now, if I ask you a question, will you all believe me? Now, owls are one of the quietest reptiles in the world. Do you all believe me? Yes, some of you look very confused, some of you say no, yes, doesn't matter, we are actually going to show you. So what Midnight is going to do is, he's going to fly across the amphitheater and land on that green stump over there. But in order for Midnight to do that, I'm going to need all of you to remain seated, and once again, please remember to switch off the flashes of your cameras. Alright Midnight, whenever you're ready, let's go. That was a very beautiful flight. Can I give Midnight a round of applause? Thank you, Midnight. Some of you might have noticed that when Midnight flew across our view, that's because Midnight was actually very silent. Now, owls actually have softer wing tips at the edges of their wings, which allows them to catch their prey without being detected at all. Now, as we all know, the main source of prey for owls will be rodents, and rodents, they have a very strong sense of smell. So, these owls, they've got to be as quiet as possible in order to catch their prey. Another interesting fact about an owl is that they have three eyelids. One is for blinking, the other one for cleaning, and the third one is for sleeping. Alright, with that being said, let's give a round of applause for Saint together with Rainbow, as well as Midnight, together with Mr. James. Thank you so much, and we'll see you much later on. Alright, so if you're wondering why Oscar is still out on stage, he is actually going to show you a behavior that most of you might find very, very interesting. And in order for that to happen, I'm going to ask you a question. And if you know the answer, please shout out as loud as you can. How many degrees do you think an owl can set its head up to? I got 360. Anymore answers? Anymore? 180. Anymore answers? Who said 270? Raise up your hand. Anybody said 270? I heard 270. No one. No one raised up your hand. Oh, there you go. Let's give the young boy a round of applause. Alright. Now, 270 degrees is the correct answer. For those of you who said 360 degrees, this will be a horror show by now, because the owl tail will be completely detached from its body. Now the reason why this owl can turn 270 degrees is very simple. Now you see, our eyeballs, we can't move up and down as well as left and right. Owls, they can't do that. So in order to have a fixed way, they have to turn their head 270 degrees. Now enough of me talking. Let us see Oscar turn his head 270 degrees. Yes? No? Yes? Alright, the head and Oscar, whenever you're ready, let's go. Oh. And there we go! That's a full 270 degree head turn. For those of you who have missed it, not to worry, Oscar will be showing it to you again. And there we have it! That's a full 270 degree head turn. As I mentioned earlier, Oscar is one of the largest owls that we have in the world. Now, in actual fact, in the world, the wingspan of the Great Eurasian Eagle Owl can exceed up to 6 feet in length, which is equivalent to the height of an average human being. Now, with that being said, let's give a round of applause for Darren as well as Oscar. Thank you guys so much. And thank you, Berlin, for taking the first bag. Now, from the Kings of the Sky, we are going to meet up with one of the cutest animals that we have here. Now, this animal is a canine, and it can be found in the savannas of Africa. And I want all of you to turn your attention towards the right-hand side, and you'll be able to spot the animal very, very soon. Now, in a sandy-colored coat, it has very, very large ears as well. Coming up with Mr. Lakshmi, everyone, this is Zaya. And Zaya is our fennec paw. Fennec foxes can be found in the savannas of Africa. And many of you might think that Zaya here is a baby. He is actually a fully grown adult. He is about 3 years old and was born right here at the night safari. Do take a look at their very large ears. Now because these animals can be found in Africa, their ears is used to dispel heat and also to hear for their prey underground. Of course, their sandy colored coat provides them as an advantage to actually escape from their predators because it also acts like a camouflage. And these animals are known to jump up twice their height, be it vertically as well as horizontally, and this also enables them to escape from their predators. Now just like all canines, fennec foxes also has a very strong sense of smell as well. Alright, now that's it. Let's give a round of applause for Zaya as well as for Mr. Lakshmi. Bye Zaya, thank you guys so much. So from the smallest species of carnivore in Africa, we are going to meet up with one of the largest species that we have. Now in order for that to happen, please remain seated and also please remember to keep your mask on. The largest carnivore that can be found in the African continent, this animal has a strong sense of smell, so strong that it is able to detect carcasses many miles away. If you take a look at the top of the border, now that will be Shaka, and Shaka is our spotted hyena. Spotted hyenas are one of the largest species of hyenas we have in the world. Hyenas have powerful jaws that allow them to crush the bones of their prey, including those of an elephant. They also have a very powerful digestive system, allowing them to digest the skin, the teeth, the bones, and even the hooves of their prey. Thank you. females tend to be more dominant than the males. They also have a very large heart, which allows them to run for long distances in search for their prey. And I'm sure many of you here might think that they are closely related to the dog, because of the canine-like features. Now in fact, these animals are actually more closely related to the cat. And speaking of cats, you'll be joined by a very beautiful and fabulous-looking feline. Well, hi Karen, you're not a feline that I was looking for. Okay, he's just setting the exhibit for this very beautiful animal to come out. She goes by the name of Cash. Everyone, there she is. Now, Cash is a slender-built turtle. Now, turtles actually resemble a miniature cheetah, except for the relatively shorter tail. They also have slender forepaws that help them dig into the burrows for their food. Now, in the wild, these turtles can jump up to 10 to 15 feet into the air to catch a bird that is slow to take off from the ground just like that. So once again, let's give a round of applause for Darren as well as for Cash. And we managed to take a look at the back of the turtles here. Now you might notice that they have black and white markings. Now those are known as oxide markings, and they actually serve as a natural deterrent against predators in the dark. Now you see, they also act as eyes in the dark and prevent other predators from peeking out from behind them to try and catch the prey of Sophie. Sophie, what are you doing? Oh, it's Sophie! Okay, everyone, this is Sophie, the raccoon that you saw earlier on. Now, unfortunately for these animals, they're actually considered as pets in the Northern American continent. Now, why is that so? Now, that's because these animals, they like to go into other people's homes, rummage in the bin, and also because they have dexterous paws, this actually allows them to open up containers just like this. And being able to open up containers means they can open up doorknobs, enter into other people's homes, causing a mess, creating a mess, and that's why they are nicknamed the Trash Panda. Okay, now many of you might think that Toppy here is an albino. He is not. If you look at him closely, he actually has beautiful brown eyes. Now, albino animals would have red eyes, and besides coming in cream color, these animals also come in black as well as in gray. And it looks like he has another container that he is actually going to open up very, very soon. And is he going to open up? Yes? No, is it too tight? Okay, let's watch him try to open. And is he getting it? Come on, Toppy, you can do this. Yep. There we go, let's give him a round of applause for Toppy. As I said, now they're actually considered as pets. But what we do not understand is that we are actually building our homes into their natural habitat, so these animals actually have got no choice but to actually come into our homes and also disturb our homes as well. Now it looks like Toppy actually has suffered a bit, so let's just see what caught Toppy's attention. Now it looks like we have a plastic bottle and also a pair of tin cans. Now all these items have one thing in common, and that is they can be Come on guys, they can be recycled and recycled. Fortunately, all of these items can disappear if we choose to use these recyclable plastic water bottles that can be found in the shops outside of the National Fire Extinguisher. Thank you very much for the recycling bin. However, myself or Sting will not be recycling the items at all. In fact, we'll be joined by two very cute animals, their sisters, and there they are here with Colin. Now, there are games of bubbles as well, Jamie, and the one that will be recycling the tin can, now that will be Bubbles, and the one recycling the plastic bottle, now that will be Jamie. Come on, baby, you got this? Sorry, Bubbles, yes. And second tin can. Come on, Bubbles. Your sister is already done. I'm going to be recycling, not juggling. Come on, you got it! There we go! Alright, how about the paper pattern? Paper pattern!
Bye-bye! You do it!
I do it! Okay, never mind, I can ask all of you to do it with me. Now the paper important message, and that is to reduce, reuse, and recycle. That is right. Our journey through the night has come to an end, but let us not forget the lessons that we have learned. From the owl in the sky, to the windstorm on the ground, to even the raccoon on the pond floor, they see all teachers a very important message, and that is not to forget their presence in the world. Now remember, all of us here can make a difference. It's just a choice of difference we want to make. After all, the greatest threat to our planet is to believe that someone else will actually save it for us. Now with that being said, I come to the end of the presentation right here at the Night Safari. This is Fun Time Together with Midnight, as well as Things Get a Rainbow. My name is Anne. All of you have been such a wonderful and great audience. Take care, stay safe, and good night!
Please remain seated and wait for our presenters or operation friends to call out to your row to exit. Now we direct you to the exit point, and once you have exited from the amphitheater, please do remember to practice social distancing by keeping at least 1 meter away from the next group of guests. With that, thank you for your understanding, stay healthy, and take care.